Kenworth of my dreams. Kenworth is a kind of truck. I sold my old Camaro. I sold my fishing boat. A friend said he would co-sign on a small commercial loan. So I shopped around till I found a rig within my means. I put $15,000 down on the Kenworth of my dreams. My sister's husband held me out when we took the thing apart, and every bolt and piston I knew them all by heart. We cleaned her out and painted her and brought her up to speed. I proudly put my name upon the Kenworth of my dreams. But sometimes lay down on some interstate, I hear those sad country songs, true love found and true love gone. Lately I just turn the damn thing off. A lot of folks just shook their heads, convinced that I'd lost mine. They said living in a goddamn truck is just a waste of time. That to spend your life behind the wheel ain't as great as it might seem. I just thanked them all and left one night in the Kenworth of my dreams. But sometimes, late out on some interstate, I hear those sad country songs, true love found and true love gone. Lately I just turn the damn thing off. A business, it's been pretty good, and I've no cause to complain. I haul bourbon up to Buffalo and frozen food to Maine. Toxic waste or Quaker state, it's all the same to me. I'll go anywhere for anything in the Kenworth of my dreams. I'll go anywhere for anything in the Kenworth of my dreams. I'll go anywhere for anything in the Kenworth of my dreams. Thank you very much. It was actually, if I had my druthers, if I were a trucker, which I'm not, I never actually even set foot in a truck like that. Truckers are shocked to find that out. They find it very disappointing to find out that things can be written accurately without having actually done them. And, I would like to do it though, but if I were to do that, I would be driving a Peterbilt. It's a brand of truck. However, the Peterbilt of my dreams doesn't have the same je ne sais quoi. Here's another highway song. There are some place names in this one you might need help with. It's a very geographically specific song, this one. It takes place on Route 80, more or less between the George Washington Bridge that crosses the Hudson River, going westbound out through New Jersey, Pennsylvania border.
the Delaware River. So we're talking about stretch of the highway between the Hudson and Delaware River, which goes past Paterson, New Jersey, home of Hurricane Carter, William Carlos Williams. And as it turns out, a nun by the name of Sister Maria, who wrote me a letter. I'll tell you about that later. And then I mentioned in the song a couple of other places. I mentioned Mincy and Tammany. Those are two hills that Route 80 goes through the middle of, where the Delaware River cuts through. And they're old. Those are Algonquin names. They're kind of the Scylla and Charybdis of Pennsylvania. The merge from the turnpike was a murder, but it's never a cinch. It was Friday at 5, and no one was giving an inch. They squeezed, and they edged, and they glared. Half of them clearly impaired by rage or exhaustion. The rest were just touchy as hell. Somewhere near Paterson, everything slowed to a crawl. The all-news station was thanking someone for the call. Van from St. Agnes's choir. There's a nun out there changing attire. By the time they got by her, tempers were out of control. So they all hit the gas in a dash for position, bobbing and weaving and flashing their high beams and flipping the bird. Screaming obscenities, a well-insured horde, hell bent on Saturday. So they continued westbound and into the sun. Law and decorum constraining nary. By then, it was devil may care. Not a one even vaguely aware that they had come all the way to the Delaware water gap. But how had it happened? They had all missed their exits. How had it happened? Was it some kind of vortex? And in they all. Bumper to bumper, faster and faster, no sign of a trooper. And in they all went, like sheep to the slaughter. Bankers and carpenters, doctors and lawyers. And in they all went, families in minivans. Democrats, Republicans, but mostly Republicans. They followed the river and rounded the bend between Mincy and Tammany and into their destiny, lying in ambush right there before them, the angry old sun right on the horizon. Sister Maria tightened the bolts of the spare. Said a quick prayer and put the old van into gear. Thank God the traffic was light. If she hurried, she might not be late for that evening's performance at the state penitentiary. She entered the common room was her choir. Altos and baritones, basses and tenors, car thieves and crack dealers, mobsters and murderers, husbands and sons, fathers and brothers. And so it began in glorious harmony, softly and tenderly, calling for you and me, with the interstate crying way off in the distance, and the sun going down through the bars of the prison. And they poured out their souls, they poured out their memories, they poured out their hopes for what's left of eternity. To Sister Maria, her soul like a prism for the light of forgiveness on all of their faces.
Thank you. Thank you. So, as I was saying about a nun named Sister Maria, I got a letter from Sister Maria, but I wrote the song without ever having checked to see if there actually was one. I just made her up. And I didn't feel I needed to check this. It's, you know, it's my song. I can just make up a nun if I want to. And I also made up the church. It's my song, I can make up a church, St. Agnes's, you know, whatever. And, good a name as any. So, a couple years went by. I was at a radio station in New York City. And this is back in the day before you could connect to people in all sorts of ways that you wish they wouldn't. And they said, "Oh, we got a letter here for you, Richard." And I said, "Really? How odd." They said, "Yeah, that happens sometimes. People send us letters here because they think that we're all in touch all the time." And anyway, I was immediately my interest was immediately piqued because the letterhead said St. Agnes, or the stationery said St. Agnes's Catholic Church, Paterson, New Jersey. So I thought, well, that's interesting. Because, there was printed. It was a real thing. They got their own stationery. It has to be real. And so I opened it up, full of curiosity, and there it was again, the letterhead on the letter itself. And then written in this great, flowing, expansive cursive was the following note. "Dearest Richard," and we're talking great loops, great, huge, just looping cursive. "Dearest Richard, please drive carefully. Yours, Sister Maria." This next song was written after 9/11. It's a simple song. You wouldn't know it's a post 9/11 song. This one is from the point of view of a taxi driver. He's just picking people up about 5 days after that in Manhattan. It's called "Last Fare of the Day." Saw them standing in the rain out on 7th Avenue. He held her close like she might fall if he let go. He helped her in, he shut the door. Our eyes met in the mirror, two angles. "Take it slow," is all he said. Into the stream we pulled away. I know it well, this old ballet. minding the flow, minding the sway, catching green lights on the way. Up Amsterdam, the meter dark. I turned off the radio. She whispered thanks. I could not bear another word. And out on the bridge, the traffic slowed. And the brake lights and the wash of all those truckers heading south on 95. Catching green lights on the way. And I brought them home. I brought them home. I brought them home in that cruel, cruel rain. And now it's spring, and where's the rain? All the wells are running dry, and the reservoirs have reached an all-time low. And if this red light ever turns, if I can make it through the park, I'll head uptown for the last fare of the day. And turn it does, I pull away. I know it well, this old ballet. Finding the flow, minding the sway, catching green lights on the way. Outside St. Luke's, with their flowers and balloons, all amazement at the baby in her arms. As Amsterdam makes us a place, I ask about her name, and we all laugh when he says hope. She says grace. And then it starts, the heavens give. I know it well, this old ballet. Finding the flow, minding the sway, catching green lights all the way. And I brought them. I brought them home in that sweet, sweet rain.
Thank you.
Here's one from my new record, which was which Richard kindly mentioned. The record is called "Careless." This song is called "The Deer on the Parkway." Late in the evening, they emerge through the trees. Can't ships and sails, sixes and threes, following true to the call they obey. Their eyes on the prize, each blade of the way. Ages ago, they roamed the king's wood. And though he would hunt them, they considered him good. The odd royal arrow, a small price to pay for keeping the poachers and freedom at bay. And the deer on the parkway graze right to the edge. I come round the bend, they're lifting their heads, my headlights, their eyes. What will they decide? Will the deer on the parkway let me pass by? Grasses grow thin by the side of the road, the strait that they're in. But the median's lush and it's luring them out, out onto the parkway where I'm heading south. She's trying to get home just like everyone else, down through the county, heaven or hell. Or if you don't kill me, friend, well, I won't kill you. That muttering king, yeah, I'm missing too. And the deer on the parkway graze right to the edge. I come round the bend, they're lifting their heads, my headlights, they're will they decide? Will the deer on the parkway let me pass by? Will the deer on the parkway let me pass by?
Thank you. All right, another highway song. I'm on a roll here. Steve Knightley played this last night with Show of Hands, and Phil sang it. It was actually Phil Beer who sang it. Did a beautiful version. I was on the side of the stage, I just couldn't believe my ears. Hello. Isn't that delightful? Reminds me of a gig I brought my daughter to when she was about 4. It's a childcare situation, one of those childcare situations, and I took my daughter to the gig with me in Massachusetts. You know, I shouldn't tell this story. she's not going to be happy about this. She's not four anymore. Well, it was the middle of the set, and I was singing this some depressing, melancholy ballad or something, and all of a sudden, and I'd hired a babysitter to watch her doing my set, it was a church coffee house kind of place, so there was a room where the kids could play. She was in there with the babysitter, and all of a sudden, she appears walking up the center aisle. I see her walking towards me. This is about that high. Just walking towards me, and it was so dark. It was like now. It was very, very dark, exactly like this. And she walks up the center aisle. I see her emerge into the light, just like this. Never let small children into your act. And she comes right up to the microphone, because we're all on the same level. It's not like she had to climb the stairs or anything. And she looks right at me, and she says, "Daddy, can you change my diaper?" And at which point the audience did what you just did. They all laughed, thought it was adorable and cute, and then she realized that there was an audience. She hadn't seen them at all, and she was mortified. She's gonna kill me. She's gonna kill me that I have told this story in public. What have I done? God, what an idiot. This is called The Next Best Western. It's the middle of the night, near the Indiana line. I'm pulling in a Christian station. The signal is crystal clear, but I cannot really hear what he says about the revelation. I am wretched, I am tired, but the preacher is on fire, and I wish I could believe. Whoever watches over all these truckers, show a little mercy for a weary sinner and deliver me. Lord, deliver me. Deliver me to the next best Western. Made the lamb with a tremble in the hand that reaches out to take my quarter. I look him in the eye, but there isn't any time, just time enough to pass the tender. The highway takes its toll, the green light flashes go. Welcome to Ohio. Whoever watches over all these truckers, show a little mercy for a weary sinner and deliver me. Lord, deliver me. Deliver me to the next best Western. Takes light years of nothing to let these stars shine through. It's an empty road that finds its way back home to you. At 4 a.m. on 8 East, it's in the nature of the beast to wonder if there's something missing. I am wretched, I am tired, but the preacher is on fire, and I wish I could believe. Whoever watches over all these truckers, show a little mercy for a weary sinner
Western to the next best Western to the next best Western.
Thank you. This is from the new album as well. Fire on the thoroughfare. No one's going anywhere. They say these are but the vestiges. Their banners look like bandages. A martyr's face, an acronym. Beat the drum and sing the hymn. Struggle red and Bible black. The riot squad is holding back. Lost an industry. Someone closed a factory. The decision unilateral. Damage done collateral. The president was in a pinch. Whose budget cuts are start to print. Basis points gone through the roof. Now what's a head of state to do? Getting what he needs, and the anchor asks, will government cave into local discontent? And high above, without a sound, the satellites keep going round. LCDs on trading floors, living rooms, appliance stores, LCDs at S&P, Moody's and Fidelity. Somewhere there's an average Joe opening an envelope. Somewhere a retiree is staring at a balance sheet. Thank you. Thank you.
May I play you another one from the new record? Thank you. This is called All Wide Open. She showed up on the doorstep out of nowhere, all wrapped up in a Goodwill overcoat. She was shaking, arms drawn tight around her. She said, "Daddy, I've been clean almost a month." With his jeweler's eye, he looked at her a moment. He stepped aside and nodded to the door wide open. Down in the closet, still wrapped up in that Goodwill overcoat. He said, "Don't you wanna hang that in the closet?" She said, "Not just yet, I'm still a little cold. And how about I put on a pot of coffee?" He said, standing at the stove now with his heart wide open and wanting to believe it could be true, but wary of another perfect life forming under pressure like a diamond and emerging flawless in her eyes. Thanksgiving is just around the corner. She asks him, "Is it all right if I stay?" And with the voice of one afraid the past is future, he says, "Why don't we just take it day by day?" And her overcoat is hanging in the closet. It looks like winter's coming on now, but it's all Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. She doesn't actually go and sit down in the closet. She goes into the kitchen. I got that wrong. I just wanted to clarify. Here's another one.
This is a weird song. This is a little anti-objectivist kind of number. Objectivism, the Ayn Rand theory, if you can call them that. I got myself into a little political state of political indignation several years ago. And it happens every once in a while. I try not to do that anymore. And it's not good for me, not good for my blood pressure. But this was one of those little political thickets you get yourself into sometime. And I wrote, tried to write my way out of it with this song. It's called Atlas Choking. Ayn is dead, she died in her bed at the end of a terrible illness. Her oxygen birth untethered from earth, she drifted up into the stillness. 11 years later, good old Yul Brynner found himself there in the ether. Dead Ayn Rand took Yul by the hand, said, "How does it feel to be free?" Meanwhile, still at it, making a killing, churning up addicts, everybody everywhere, sucking in Ayn's air. Atlas choking. Well, big tobacco sent flowers around with a note and a basket of options. If you know what's good for you, hold on to these, cause everything's gonna go up, up, up. Greenspan and Stockman leading the horsemen, the party was just getting started. The Marlboro man rode into Japan, looked over the water to China. All over the planet, the devil's still at it, making a killing, churning out addicts, everybody everywhere, sucking in Ayn's air. Atlas choking. Rational greed, the national creed, will keep things smoking along. Watching those shares, but don't you dare share. The poor are that way for good reason. Everyone just hush, utopia's flush, and beckoning off in the long run. Meanwhile, on the planet, the devil's still at it, making a killing, churning out addicts, everybody everywhere, sucking in Ayn's air. Atlas choking. Thank you. There was a request for this one. It's called Wisteria. Let's not drive away just yet. Give me a moment more to walk through those rooms again, to walk through. through that door. If we turned off the radio, I'd only need to close my eyes, and the wind in the sycamores will carry me home. Vine of my memory is blooming around those eaves, but it's true, it's a chore to tame. Tempted to ring the bell. Maybe they'd ask me in. Or maybe it's just as well to let it all be. Remember the price we paid. Seemed like a lot back then. Remember the love we made the day we moved in. The vine of my memory is blooming around those. True, it's a chore to tame. Wisteria, wisteria. Did need some pruning back, and I know that it's not my place, but how could they just cut it down and leave not a trace? But let's not drive away just yet. Give me a moment more to walk through those dreams again, to walk through that door. The vine of my memory still blooms all around. Wisteria, wisteria. Thank you very much. I'm gonna do one more for you here, and then I don't know what's gonna happen. Sorry. That's been a while since I did that one. It's an excellent request. Thank you. I appreciate it, but I can't do that. I would just hack it. I'd just be terrible. It'd be a disaster.
fast. Yeah, that was a similar problem there, but that was. Where do you hear this one?
Your favorite one.
Speaking of my daughter, this is her favorite. It's because her one of her childhood birds. Birds, they don't live as long as you want them to. And so we had three. We had there was Gloria, and then there was Che. I live in Argentina, so there was Che, whose real name was Ernesto, but we called him Che for short. And then there was Mavis, short for Mavis Rara. It's a little Latin joke. This song's called "There Goes Mavis," and it's a song about a bunch of guys building sandcastles at the beach on Cape Cod, a beach called Newcomb Hollow Beach, not Newcomb as in N-U-K-E apostrophe E-M, you know, no, as somebody, not Newcomb Hollow, just but N-E-W-C-O-M. Hollow. They're building sandcastles there, the guys, the uncles, the brothers, the sons. It's a guy thing. They're doing battle with the ocean, as we do, you know, the futility of, you know, building the ramparts and everything and trying to keep the waves from coming in. It's great fun and ultimately futile. And that was what was happening with my song. The song was going nowhere, and I was about to abandon it. And my daughter's bird just flew into the song. It was like a M.C. Escher painting, and here's the song, and it starts off with a bunch of guys at a beach, and then there's this visitation of the bird. But before I go, I'd like to say thank you to all of you for coming and for having me back here again. This is now the third, or maybe even the fourth time I've been here, and it's just so wonderful to come back here. It's great. I love it. I love playing in the UK, and everybody's so kind here, and I've made some friends, and I hope I can just keep coming back. So thank you. And I got these great red shoes for £10 the other day. Beach at Newcomb Hollow, last days of August, the other side of low tide, sun is high, we're kneeling in the wet sand, propping up a wall breach, quick before the next wave, rushes in, rushes in. The moat around the castle is filling up with water, but hope springs eternal. All hands ready, here it comes. Behind us in the crowd, some kind of commotion. A little girl is shouting, fly away, fly away. But we pay no attention. The castle is in danger. The ramparts are sinking. We dig on, we dig on. Out of the blue, there's an orange canary on our
driftwood flagpole. Shovels down, boys, step away.
Seven,
and her mother is behind her with a cage, with a cage. And her mother is explaining, baby, it's just too far, and she'll never survive here on her own, on her. Talking to the bird, Mavis, you can trust me. Now's your big chance. Fly away.
Mavis has been listening. She isn't letting on.
We're all just waiting. No one moves. No one moves. And then comes the big one, swamping the castle. But no one is watching. When it falls, when it falls. We're following the progress of a little bolt of orange on the long horizon. There goes
thank you very much.
Mine looks like a clone, you.
good song. It's a great song.
It's a fine song.
I'll just disappoint you.
What do you like?
Besides, I brought this lovely bouzouki, which I bought here at the Shrewsbury Festival. Loved these many years ago, and I haven't played it yet. It's just been sitting there forlorn. I've been feeling guilty. I've been noticing it. I knew it was there. I was feeling badly about not using it. And so now's my chance. This is called The Ballad of Mary Magdalene. My name is Mary Magdalene. I come from Palestine. Please excuse these rags I'm in, but I've fallen on hard times. Long ago, I had my work. When I was in my prime, but I gave it up and all for love. It was his career or mine. Jesus loved me, this I know, but why on earth did I ever let him go? He was always faithful, he was always kind, but he walked off with this heart of mine. Now love like this will come but once. This I do believe, and I'll not see his like again as I live and breathe. And I'm sorry if I might offend, but I will never see how the tenderness I shared with him became heresy. Jesus loved me, this I know, but why on earth did I ever let him go? He was always faithful, he was always kind, but he walked this heart of mine. But I remember nights we spent whispering our creed, our rituals, our sacrament, and the stars, our canopy. And there beneath an olive tree, we'd offer up our plea. God's creation, innocent, in his arms surrounding me. Jesus loves me, this I know, but why on earth did he ever have to go? He was always faithful, he was always kind, but he walked off with this heart.
this heart of mine.
Whoa.
Thank you all. Good night.
Well, as Richard said, neither of us can remember whether this is his third or fourth Shrewsbury, but it's certainly not going to be his last. You can guarantee he'll be back. And in the meantime, take a little bit home with you. Go and buy the album from the Roots Records stand. We've got something completely different for you next. It's going to take us a few minutes to get sorted out up here, but we'll be back with you as soon as we can. Thank you.